Welcome back to Exfoli. Excited for learning. So today we're going to do a little project plucking mangoes. So let's get started. This is my project, and if you drag the stone and then you it launches, and then if you touch any of the mangoes, then the mangoes will fall down automatically. Not automatically, we have to code, but it will fall. So let's see how does this work. These are the files that I've used to make this project. So elastic.js, stone.js, boy.png, index.html, mango.png, sketch.js, stone.png. The PNGs are the pictures, so we don't have to do anything with that. But anything like JS ones are what we have to create, okay? So, first let's go into the specific task to complete for this project, okay? So, create a blueprint for the stone class. Create a stone object from the blueprint. Okay, so these are the physics properties that you have to type in. So first let's go into the stone class, since they mentioned stone class first thing. So stone.js, yes. So the stone.js. So these are the properties. So first I kept static false. So I think, yeah. Restitution is 0, friction is 1, and density is 1.2. Okay. So this is the stone class. First constructor x, y, and r, because stone is first like a circle, and then we'll add the image to that. Okay, so this dot x equals to x, this dot y equals to y, this dot r equals to r. So this dot image equals to load image, so we are going to load the image first. They have given stone dot png for the stone image. So then this dot body equals to bodies dot circle, and then in brackets this dot x comma this dot y comma this dot r, and then options. So first we are adding this stone, this object or the thing stone, into first we are creating it this dot body, and then it's a circle, so bodies dot circle, and then all the properties like this dot x, that's the x position, this dot y is the y position, this dot r is the radius, and options. So we have to follow all of these, right? So it should apply to that object, right? So that's the reason options is also important. World dot add world comma this body, this dot body. So we are adding this body, which is the stone, in the world. Okay, next to the display function, it is the same. Okay, so where stone position pos is short form equals to this dot body dot position. So stone pos means the this dot body dot position. So that means the body position of the stone, the stone's position. Okay, so this is you can write anything directly, position or s pos or something like that. I chose stone pos. And then these all are syntax. So translate stone pos dot x comma stone pos dot y dot y. So rotate this dot body dot angle. Okay, so this angle, I copy pasted this from I'm not sure from where I copy pasted this, and I added all the properties needed for a circle. So it's not rect mode, it's ellipse mode. So that's the reason it should be like this. Ellipse mode is only for the circle, and rect mode is for a rectangle, square, or anything except a circle. And then, okay. So this is the color of the stone. It's not necessary, since our stone is it's an image, and the image already has the color. Right, so that's the reason. Then this is push and pop is really important. Then this dot image, this dot image, comma 0, comma 0, this dot r, and then star 2 times 2, this dot r times 2. Okay, so this is how we write for the image, for applying the image. So then after doing all of this, then you, a very important thing is you have to add this in the index.html. So whatever class you make, or whatever, sorry, file you make, suppose I made sketch.js, then tree.js, no, I didn't make tree.js, ground.js, and mango.js, but stone.js and elastic.js was made by me. So we have to add it in index.html. Otherwise, you are not making it apply. So in index.html, you're saying that read this class or read this file, that apply this. Okay, so like that. I have a little cold. So that's the stone.js, and then I'll first go in sketch.js. So these are the plucking mangoes, sketch.js. Okay, so that was, we'll start with the constants, engine equals matter.engine, world, bodies, body. So this everything was given. Actually, in fact, one mango was already made. Okay, so one mango was already made, so that's the reason you don't have to do anything, you just have to use them. Okay, so this everything was given, except I added the mangoes, more mangoes, only one mango was given, so I added few more mangoes, and then I create a variable stone and elastic. Okay, so next in function setup, what you have to do is that mango 1 equals to new mango, so we have to apply this class. This class was already created by them. Okay, so we have to create multiple. It's really easy, but you have to look at the positions where the tree is. So you have to keep checking whether this is right on the tree or it's somewhere else flying. Okay, so, and next, this is very easy. You have to, these positions are up to you. Wherever you want, you can keep them. So if you want little up like that, and you can create more. I just created 7. You could create more, like 8, 9, or you could leave it by 5, 6 of them. Okay, so then we are creating the stone. Okay, and then this tree object, this everything was given by them already, except this new elastic. This was created by me. I'll show you the elastic class. So this is the elastic class. It's like the same as the slingshot class of Angry Birds. Okay, so class elastic, so we are connecting a body A, a body, and a point. So we are connecting one point in the canvas and body. It could be any body you wish for. Now right here we are connecting the point which is near to the boy's hand approximately, and the stone. Okay, so there are options. Then body A equals to colon body A, point B colon point B, stiffness is 0.04 and length is 10. Okay, so you can see that it's a minimal amount, 10 is. So if you increase this 10, then the length between the hand and the stone, like, it would be dangling. Okay, now right here I cannot edit it since I already uploaded this in GitHub. Okay, then this point B equals to point B, then this dot elastic equals to constraint create, and then bracket options. Okay, so constraint, we are creating a constraint, so we are applying the constraint onto this object, and options, so we are applying the options. So whatever they are in the options, body A, colon body A, stiffness, length, point B, these all are there in the options. So we are applying it. Okay, next, world.add world, comma, this dot elastic. So you are adding this dot elastic into the world. And then there are two functions that we have created extra. So attach and fly. Okay, so these both are for, now as you can see the stone is not there, but when I press the space key, then you can see that the space comes into my hand. Okay, so why does it happen? I'll show you. I'll reload it. And then once more, when I just leave it, it flies. And then when I press the space key, it comes back. So this is because of the attach function. And it is flying when I release the mouse because of the fly function. Okay? Okay. It's an attach and then in brackets body. This dot elastic dot body A equals to body. So this dot elastic dot body A equals to body. So body A equals to the body. So we are attaching the elastic and the body when the attach function is used, or is used. Okay, so this dot elastic dot body A equals to body. So whatever is this in this body, whichever we write, suppose we write the stone, then it will become this dot elastic dot body A. So it will become into that, which automatically means that it's near the hand, because it's coming back into like this dot elastic dot body A, which means it's like connecting to the hand again. Okay, and then fly function means that this dot elastic dot body A equals to null. So we are disconnecting the connection between elastic and the body A. Okay, whatever the body A is, which is in our case the stone. Display. If this dot elastic dot body A, then in bracket, a brace bracket, where point A equals to this dot elastic dot body A dot position, and point B equals to this dot point B. Point A is the body A's position at this point of time, and point B is the point B where we are attaching it, like point in a canvas. Okay, and then the stroke weight. So there's a line you could see. So whenever you can see a line over there, so that it's weight, stroke weight. Stroke weight means the thickness is 4. Okay, so I kept it as 4. And we are connecting a line between the point A, which is the body, and point B, X position, Y position. That means the canvas. Okay, so we are connecting a line between both of them. So this is the elastic function. Now let's see how do we use it, like the attach function and the fly. Okay, so first we created all of these, so we have to display them in this manner: mango one dot display and then brackets, bracket open close. Next, we will discuss that afterwards. Now, function mouse dragged matter dot body dot set position, then stone dot body, mouse x and mouse y. So, this is the function used for dragging it. Okay, so when mouse dragged, so see, it is dragging when I click it hard and then I'm dragging it, then it moves, right? So I'm dragging it and then it gets a force back and then it shoots out again. Okay, so we are pulling it and then just doing that. So for this to happen, now I'm moving my mouse like this, but when I press and drag it, then only it happens. So for it to happen like that, we have to type a specific code. So this is how: function mouse dragged matter dot body dot set position. So matter dot body dot set position, so set position of this we are saying. Okay, then x and then mouse x and then in comma y colon mouse y, and this everything is in brace bracket and then it is in a bracket. Okay, so we are saying that whenever a mouse is dragged, then the matter dot body dot set position, so this body's, which is at this point of time stone, then its position will be according to mouse X and mouse Y. Okay, so this is how you write the dragged one. Next, function mouse released. So now if so we want it to fly, we don't want it to be connected to the hand still, right? Point B. So we want it to fly. So for that, if you don't have this code, so yeah, if you don't have this mouse released code, then what would happen is that this stone will still be attached to the hand, but it will move, but it cannot go so nicely. Okay, so it will still be attached to that point, which we don't want. So that's the reason we are doing that. We are using the fly function. So I already told you that elastic.fly, the fly function is, I'll show it to you again. Flies elastic. So the fly function is that fly this dot elastic dot body A equals to null. So the connection between elastic and body A is null. So there's no connection between both of them. Elastic, which is the string kind of thing, and body A, which is the stone. So there's no connection between both of them. This fly function says that. So we are applying it over here. Mouse release. So whenever the mouse is released, then the connection between the body, like the elastic, and the stone will be disconnected, or it will be null. Okay, so let's go into the next one. Function detect collision. We'll do it afterwards. Now let's do function key pressed. Okay, if key code, and then 3 equals 2, or 2 equals 2 also work, but my teacher taught me as 3 equals 2, so I'm using that. Okay, if key code equals 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 to 32. Okay, so you'll learn this after a few classes, like in after, I'm not sure when, but 32 means that whenever the space key is pressed, the key code 32 is for the space key. Okay, so whenever you press, you write this key code 32, then it automatically means that when you press the space key. So before, we used to write like this: key down space, then it should happen, right? But now it's key code equals 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 to 32. Like as like the space, you learn for different things, like the up arrow, down arrow, left arrow, right arrow. Okay, so you learn for all of them as well. So this is a key code 32 means the space key. Okay, and then matter.body.setPosition. So if the space key is pressed, then matter.body.setPosition. So stone, so matter.body.setPosition, we have already used that. So matter.body.setPosition means this bodies, whichever the body is as at this point of time, it is a stone. So its position would be 235 and y position would be 420. So first I'll show you why is it 235 and 420. Because I've created the line over here. So the elastic at 235 and 420. So I want it to be exactly in the same place. So that's the reason. And length of the string that is connecting like the line at first is 10. So we want it to look like it joined back onto his hand. So that's the reason. Now some of you might be wondering that I kept 200 and 340 right here. But this doesn't matter unless the length is short. So now we're keeping the elastic one point, like the point on canvas is 235, 420. So, and the length is very minimal, which is 10. So it will be really close. So the rubber band can't stretch more. So it will get the object closer to it of the starting point, right? So that's what happens in this as well. So whatever you write this code, it doesn't matter, but it will just go according to the point. Okay. So we have to be really careful. Like we might be changing this, but still, the object wouldn't change its position. So we have to look at the chain class first, and then we could change this. Okay. So, we were right here. So, matter.body.set position, and then the point was like 235, 420. So, that's the reason. Stone.body, then 235, 420. So, that means that the stone body will come back to 235 and 420 when the space key is pressed. Okay, so then when the space key is pressed, we also want this to be attached back. So it is, this itself doesn't work. You have to add one more thing. Now we are using the attach function over here. The body should come, but so see, the stone body comes back to that position. It doesn't mean that the connection between both of them is there, right? It will come. But now the stone doesn't have any, is static, it's not true, it's false. So that means it will have a gravity. So we want the connection between the elastic and the stone to be joined back. If you write only this, then the stone will just come over there, but it will fall again. So we don't want that. So elastic.attach stone.body. We have already discussed what's the attach function. So we are using it over here. Now let us go to the detect collision. So this is a new thing that we have learned. So this was then the specific, this was part of the additional goal, I think. Yeah. So they have given. Now let's see what is this. So function detect collision. This detect collision, you can write it as anything, collision or detect or whatever you wish for. Okay, so then, and then bracket stone comma mango. Okay, so we haven't made any class or anything for this, but so mango body dot position equals to mango dot body dot position. So we are just saying that this equals to this and this equals to this. Okay, so and then we are using it over here. So where distance equals to dist, and then in brackets, so stone body dot position x, then body dot position y, you know, like where distance equals to this. Okay, so distance equals to stone body dot position dot x y mangoes x y. Okay, so now we are applying this. If distance is less than, so if this distance is less than or equal to mango dot r plus stone dot r, so if mango dot r plus stone dot r, this has a calculation which I don't know as well. This is just what they have given for us to do it. So here, yes, here. So this is a calculation that they have given to detect collision. We have learned in our classes to how to detect collision, right? So that we are using right here. This is just a formula to detect collision. Okay, then if it detects collision, then what would happen? Then matter.body.setStatic. So now we are making the static, we are changing the static. Okay, so before the mangoes is static in options was true, but now it should be false. So before we wanted it to stick onto the tree, right? But now when the stone touches it, we want it to fall down, right? Like whenever we throw a stone on a mango or any fruit, then it should come down, right? The connection between will break sometimes if you're good at it. So we want that to happen in this game. So that's the reason we have to make the set static false. So if static is false, then it will fall down. Its gravity will be activated. And if it's true, then it will stick onto that place. Okay? So now we want it to fall down. So we kept set static and then mango.body equals to false. So the object mango.body is static, the statics is false. Okay, now let's discuss this part. Fill 0, so I want the text black, so 0. Text size is 20, so the text size is 20. How big you want it or how small you want it. Okay, and then text and then brackets, press space to get another chance to play. So you can see right here that there's a space to get another chance to play. So this is showing that if you want another chance to play, this, how will anyone know when you don't write it that there's, you want, they can get another chance if they press the space key. So that's the reason this is important. And then text, and then the position is 50, 50, and then the size is 400. That's it. Very simple. So this is up to you, the size or the wording you want to change it, like press space to get a second chance or anything you want. So you could you could text anything, and this mostly depends on you. So how you want it, the size should be. So the variables and the mango, like which position should it be? This is up to you. Some of them are up to you. So this is the basic format of the project. This was pretty easy because most of them was given by them, because mango one was already created and you just need to create some more. And stone and elastic, which we have already learned, is pretty easy as well. So this was the project, and if you like this video, please like, share and subscribe. Don't forget to comment any doubts or questions in the comment section below. Thank you. Bye.